Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode of ARK. How you doing? How you doing? Hopefully it's been good for you. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the last episode where we got this guy. Crazy green fire spitting craziness. Yes, well the craziness has just begun. Let's just gamma up here because it's the middle of the night. I was actually sitting here waiting for this red beacon to go down, because I'm level 100. Let's get some red beacons, right? Oh, that's K-mode. Whee! So a decent amount has actually happened since I tamed this guy. I've been able to tame a couple of other drakes, and... yeah, I'm starting to build myself a bit of an army, because eventually I've got to do that. I mean, I've got to... well, let's put it this way. I was talking with Kat, and we were kind of discussing about Prime Alphas. Let's see what we got here quickly, actually. Celestial Alpha Dire Bear Legendary Alpha Spinum. Alright. I was hoping to get a better Drake saddle, but that's okay. Let's go back up on my rock here. As you might know, if you're familiar with Anunnaki Genesis, the little icons in the bottom left there, they are given by this stuff, the Alpha Armor. Now this stuff is rare loot, I'm pretty sure it's rare loot, from Prime Alphas. Now Prime Alphas are considerably hard to kill. And I have been fortunate enough to find a couple of little ones. They were dodos and dillos. And that's where I got this armor from. It's pretty low level. It's uncommon and rare. I mean, still though, it's pretty epic. I mean, look at the durability. 1664 on that thing. That's incredible. And the buffs they give is great as well. The underwater vision is from the helmet and the increased damage resistance is from the chest piece. And that's pretty cool. It basically allows me to take some less damage. Always good. Yay, we'll take that. And see underwater as if I had scuba goggles, even though I don't. So that's cool as well. Now, I do want to be able to finish up the set. So I need an army. I need to start being able to take out these Prime Alphas rather than just running the other direction. Or in the case of things like the Dodos and the Dillos, you can just outrun them no problem, or they just don't attack you. But, you know, like, there's Prime Alpha Sarcos and Prime Alpha T-Rex and Carno and Triceratops and Stegosaurus. I can't do anything to them. I have to just avoid them. So I'm building an army. Now, I've had a bit of luck already today, and, you know, that does kind of mean that this episode is a little bit backwards, but that's okay. I originally came to this island because I need this stuff, the charcoal. Now, I'm not sure if I get more charcoal for hitting it with an axe. No, that actually gets me... okay, let's try it this way. Nope, I think attacking it with the Drake is the best way to get the charcoal. Because Drake saddles require charcoal. And... I need Drake saddles. That's pretty much it. So I'm going to be here. I'm going to be gathering some charcoal. I'm going to be gathering a few other materials. I will toss in the clips of what I've been up to this morning, and then we'll bring you back and we'll get working on expanding the army that I've already started. It's Fire Drake. I'm gonna get this one. I'm gonna get it. I need it. Hey, don't attack my Sabertooth. He's not for lunch. You're for lunch. Go to sleep. Go to sleep. Oh, hey, it's running. Look at that. Quickest Drake battle ever. Yes, stuck in a wall. That's just perfect. I love it when they get stuck in walls. Hey, night-night. Look over there in the distance. It's another Fire Drake. This one... a nice level 520. Might take a little longer to knock out because it's a higher level. But... I want it. I need it. Part of my army. Oh yes, chomp, chomp, chomp. Alright. Come on. Oh, you can go down anytime. Anytime. Come on. Go to sleep. How about now? Man, I realize you're a higher level, but jeepers. Toddler not wanting to take a nap. Go to sleep. Come on. Yeah, keep circling. Come on. This guy is just resisting all my torpor. Come on, go to sleep. Yes. No. Here I thought I had it stuck for a moment. Oh well. Come on. Come on. Oh. Oh, yes. Yes, yes, yes. You gonna stop here? Nope, you're sliding down. Okay, all the way to the bottom we go. Look at this guy. He's just sitting up here all by his lonesome. All alone. Let's check him out. It is a lovely Alpha T-Rex. I think I'll add that to my army. Oh, hey. Whoa! Flying T-Rex! Come back here. You're not allowed to fly. You don't got wings. Get out of the pond. Well, I guess it would be a wading pool for you. Get out of the wading pool. It's closed. Yeah, I think an Alpha T-Rex would do great for an army. Alright, it's no Drake, but... Eh? I could see uses for it, that's for sure. Suffocate it in dragon gas. I know biting it would do better, but... Then it would bite me back. I don't want to be bitten back. I wanted to go to sleep. Go to sleep. Now. Nope. Alright. Keeping at it, I guess. Alright. Finally got the thing asleep. Let's get prime meat and a sedative narcotic. Alrighty. Lovely 425. We'll tame that up in a jiffy. And we can add it to the army of drakes that are, you know, taking up all my space. Oh, well. Hi there. That was quick. You got good stats for starter. You do, you do. Alright, let's get away from that Prime Alpha I saw back there. Come on. Oh, there you go. And... Okay. Get rid of this guy. Should be no problem at all. Yeah, level 60. Not a problem. You guys stay here. Because I see another Alpha T-Rex. It's a lower level, but it's male, and I'm pretty sure this one is female. Indeed. Which means we can get a mated pair. That would be pretty awesome. So they're going to stay with it. Well, they're going to wander because they're drakes, but oh well. Let's grab the prime meat off of this one. Because I'm going to need that. Get a sedative narcotic out and ready. And let's go knock us out a second Alpha D-Rex. Da-da-da. Clear the area. Don't want nothing chewing on it once I knock it out. Far too many times has that happened, and then you lose taming efficiency and you're like, oh man, I gotta let the thing wake up just because, you know, this little raptor that you didn't see came and chewed on it. Check your surroundings, clear the area, then knock out your target. Gotta get this T-Rex Stego out of here. You're not important as compared to the Alpha Rex. Go to sleep. Or die, whichever you prefer. I don't care. I just want you gone. Going to sleep. I think he's gonna go to sleep over there. Stego's asleep. Yeah, good. T-Rex is asleep. As is the Alpha. Something flying around in the background. It's okay. Oh, this is taming up real quick. Hey! Alrighty. Now I'm gonna have a mated pair of Alpha T-Rexes. Ah, can you hear it? Can you hear it? Hey, Poison Drake. Don't got too many of those. I've been finding fire mostly today. So, oh, loud music. Loud music. There we go. Okay, Poison Drake, come on. Follow the pretty birdie. Oh, he's gonna get distracted on everything. That's okay. Everything will just get knocked out. It's all good. Let's get him. Come on. Go to sleep. He's not too high of a level, so it shouldn't take too long. Where'd he go? There he is. There he is. Oh, when he's asleep. Look at that. Alrighty. Down to the ground. Ooh, Prime Alpha right there. We're gonna have to watch for that. Alrighty, well, time for a change of pace and a change of plans. As you just saw, I've tamed myself quite the army there. I've got myself two Fire Drakes, a Poison Drake, and two Alpha T-Rexes, mate boosted, so we will be able to make some Alpha babies, which should be pretty cool. Now, originally, I had planned to just, you know, make a bit of a structure and keep them nice and safe. Well, in between then and now, the server's updated, and the mod pack has updated, and we have actually added in the Stargate mod. So that's pretty cool. So first off, we will need the ancient bench, because that's what's used to craft the Stargate. And it helps if I spell it right. And with the Stargate mod, not only comes the Stargate, but comes the teleporter rings. So we'll also have some fun with that. So this will allow me to, if I can again spell properly, which apparently I can't. Oh, shush. it'll allow me to bring everything home just fine. So we need 400 metal, 50 crystal, and 50 electronics. That is not a problem. That's actually really cheap. But chances are it's intended for earlier game. I mean, we've been playing a little bit, so
just a bit.
craft us up an ancient bench. Put that stuff away, because I really don't know what I'm going to need. How big is... Oh, it's not that big. I'm kind of running out of places to put stuff, though. This house was never intended to be the only place. Like, I do intend to have multiple buildings. So I think the house dodo is going to have to be outside for a little bit. I know. It's a travesty.
He served the house well.
He will go into the house proper. This is like the crafting shed.
That's a big shed.
Yeah, well, there's a lot of crafting. So the ancient bench, which, for anyone who's actually a fan of Stargate, you'll know exactly where this comes from. This is actually a control panel, which is really interesting. Okay, so what's required for the Stargate? Oh, that's what else I'm missing. I need a ZPM. Alright, so the Stargate requires 200 metal, 10 electronics, 100 obsidian. That might be an issue, we'll see. So we need electronics. Plenty of those. Actually, do I have any obsidian? I do! Look at that! And I even got some metal. It's perfect. No, I don't need spoiled meat in there.
Sure you do.
Let's craft a Stargate with spoiled meat! It'll be the worst Stargate ever.
I ain't touching that.
Yeah, no, don't go through that one. Okay. Oh, I can craft 47 ZPMs. Wow, Atlantis, eat your heart out. Oh my. Oh, this is going to take like 5 minutes to craft. All right. In the meantime, let's get more metals so that we can craft more than one. Because it really... isn't very helpful to have one Stargate. Where am I going to go with it? Craft 4. Sure.
Why not?
Yeah, we can craft 4.
It's getting brighter. Oh god, can't see.
I guess that makes 5 in total, so we'll craft 5 ZPMs. And we'll let those craft up. In the meantime, song and dance? Alrighty, so now let's find a spot for this Stargate, and I say over here. Why? Because.
That's the best answer ever.
If you were looking for a real reason...
you come to the wrong place.
Exactly. You are watching the wrong YouTuber. Alright, so if my guess is correct and this thing is four foundations.
Sorry, I just watched a Lobie direwolf run right into the pack.
Okay, where's the Stargate? Stargate, hello! Oh! There you are! Rotate. Rotate, please. Please? Please, no. Well, okay, apparently it's bigger than I thought.
Oh, great.
5 foundations.
6 foundations.
Why no place there? Oh, you can place there. Place. Yes! It's a Stargate! Holy moly, that is big! Wow. Okay.
Capacity is killing me.
So, from what I've heard, the DHDs do not work with Anunnaki or something like that. So, may as well just poof it. So, let's rename the Stargate, because otherwise we won't know where this is. So we will call it Cat and Test Base. And with a single stone... No, where is it? Is it under miscellaneous? Where are you? Navigation, there it is. With a single stone, we can craft a remote. So let's craft us a remote. Ta-da. We has a remote. And do I click a button? How do I use this thing? Ah! There it is. Clicky clicky. Okay. So it can see my gate, although it's not active because I don't have a ZPM in it. The ancient bench should be done crafting. Well, almost done crafting, but I've got a ZPM at least. And we will stick it in the stargate. There. And it goes into the trophy slot. And it should be active now. We are part of the Stargate network. Woo-hoo! No Goa world. Now, to grab more Stargates. And we get to have fun sprinkling them all over the world. Approaching the Arctic outpost, which is going to be the site of our next Stargate. And the site of a kitty cat.
Ooh.
Boom! Here I am.
Jump over your tail.
Let me out of the wings.
Gonna get you.
I mean, I like wings as much as the next person, but jeepers. Crap! Nobody saw that.
Nobody saw that.
Shush! You didn't see anything. There we go. 5 foundations.
You're such a cute little kitty. You sure are. You're cute.
No, I'm not talking about myself.
There we go. Stargate.
Funny. I mean, you made me think it was, like, way bigger than that.
It's huge!
In relative, it's probably pretty much the size of a Stargate compared to Homo sapiens or humans or... I don't know. It's been a while since I've actually watched Stargate. The movie. I only like the movie.
Alright, well this one should be active, so remote in hand. Is it right click or left click? Right click. Available addresses. Cool.
Ready for a test?
Go on through. If you show up at base, you're good.
Oh, that is really cool. I showed up on base and it just looks like a... it's a little... When you go through it, it's a little glitchy because there are no trees or no mountains.
Let's find out. Woof. Oh. Hello.
There. Oh, I just gotta run a little bit up here.
You gotta wait for the load time, yeah. Boop. There they are. There they are.
I'm home, yay.
Yeah, well, it's understandable. I thought it was supposed to disconnect when you go through it.
So it's still active on the other side?
There it goes. It's timed, apparently. I guess it allows you to take through multiple dinosaurs and stuff like that. So now, if you're wanting a remote, all you have to do is just remote. It doesn't cost any engram points, and it costs 1 stone to craft it.
Okay, my bird's stuck.
How is your bird's... What did you do?
I went to jump up onto the roof and slid into that corner.
How?
You're asking me how. This is the same person...
Oh, there it goes.
...between tree... I'm by a tree, a rock, and water.
Alright.
In my engram thing...
Yeah, search for, what's it called? Stargate Remote. Alright, well, we've got ourselves a gate here on the floating island, and I've got most of the army through. It's just these last 2 drakes. So I'm hoping I can get them through this time. So let's pull up the remote. Dial the base. Oh, No, it failed that time. Maybe because Drake was too close. Let's try again. There we go. Okay, now, are you gonna go through? Go through. Go through the gate, you silly Drake. I don't want to have to come back just for one Drake. But it looks like I'm gonna have to. Of course. That figures. Aw. Dang it. Oh well, I guess it's relatively realistic. As in the Stargate show and movie, you can't go back through the gate. You gotta dial out again. It's just that's a little inconvenient. Just to go back and get one Drake. Well, there we go. That time it let me through. Now where's my Drake? There's my Drake.
Fine.
Oh. You know, it'd be really nice if the Drakes would land. Ooh, ooh. That's low enough. That's low enough. I can reach you. Saddle.
Oh, I leveled up. Yay!
Oh, of course. Whatever.
That sounded really bad, but...
Eh.
It's better than the swear words that I'm thinking.
Yeah, probably. Through the gate. There we go. There we go. All the Drakes are home.
Oh, thank God.
Indeed.
Small jump.
Alrighty. So that brings the total to...
A lot.
What? Four Fire Drakes and two Poison Drakes, along with two Alpha T-Rexes. Now I think what needs to happen... Can you come on over here, Rexy Rexy?
Fudge.
Rexy is stuck. What are you stuck on? Well, you're stuck on cinnamon. And glazed donut. You were in the dessert aisle, I see.
Yum, yum, yum. Spell.
Alright, come over here. There you go. I was going to say, you can't... Now you're stuck on Zippy. Of course, you're just going to get stuck on everything. And of course, now Zippy is stuck on you. Ay vey. You know, Alpha T-Rex, you are just a pain in the butt.
Oh, hollow you.
There you go. Come on. Alright. Get this Drake out of the way. Oh, and I saw a cool design for a, like a Drake perch type thing. Like you were talking about.
Mm-hmm. Cool.
Might have to build one of those pretty soon, especially with how many Drakes we're getting. Anyway.
It's done.
What we're going to try and do... We're going to try and make an alpha baby. Are you ready for the spamming? Whatever, it's almost done.
very weak ambulance siren.
There we go. There's a nice egg. Disable wander, disable wander. And we're gonna have to pick up the egg because it's too cold. Alrighty. Well, after much, much, much whistling, you know, also much to the enjoyment of the kitty cat here.
Oh, yes.
Who was so entertained by the incessant and virulent whistling.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
So what we're going to need to do, is craft a bunch of air conditioners. So we will need some gasoline.
I need food.
You should get food then. Electronics and crystal. Actually, I know exactly where those are. They're in here. Electronics and crystal. Alrighty, stick those in there. Turn her on. I don't think we need to make 12. Let's make 6. That ought to do it just fine.
I'm gonna reach up there. Quetzal.
The Quetzal. It solves everything! Ew, it's an earthquake! It's an earthquake! Okay. Now then, where to put the air conditioners for breeding? Right here, maybe? Because I don't think it can be inside. Well, don't step on me. No steppy on me with Quetzal. Hey, I know, we can put it on the roof.
There you go.
Well, yeah, but the ladder doesn't go all the way up.
Nope. You need to
fly. I don't know why, but for some reason, we can try and try and try, and we can't seem to put a ladder up on that last piece.
Just like our minds, things don't go all the way to the top floor.
Yeah. That's okay. All right. So set out something like a dish. That ought to do. Egg incubating! Yay! Well, sad to say, but that's gonna be the end of the episode. Time kinda dragged on. So, be sure to come back for next episode and see how this egg hatches. Yay for the eggs. So, leave a like, give me a comment. Hell, throw your bid in as to what gender it is. Yes, they can hear me. Oh no! I'm gonna hide now. Alright, guys. Bye-bye.